Okay. We are going to listen to Billie Eilish's new album. And I'm gonna give you my honest review and reaction. I'm kind of a stickler for new albums. I don't like new things. It's a wonder how I like any album ever. But yeah, anyway. Okay, first track, Skinny. Ooh. Okay.
With a friend, it's a good sign. People say I look happy just because I got skinny. But the old me is still me, and maybe the real me, and I think she's pretty. And you said I was your secret, and I didn't get to keep it. And the internet is hungry for the meanest kind of funny.
Wait, is. Huh. Wait. Okay, sorry. I thought the first lyric being, I fell in love for the first time. I thought that that was about whoever lunch is about. But I think it's about Jesse. I think, which is crazy. Who, what the fuck, what's his last name? It's the guy from the neighborhood. Rutherford? Yeah, this dude. Yeah, Jesse the neighborhood. You know what I mean. This is like very like the guitar in this is very technical. Like the chord progressions are very cool. The real question is this song going to go into lunch? Is it going to? I bet it is. Of course it leads into the next song. God, I'm a fucking. Okay, so Skinny, good song. Like that song. Very, very pretty. It's very obvious what it's about. I thought that it was going to be about something else. So let's listen to Lunch. I've heard, you know, snippets of Lunch because, you know, I'm excited.
Dances on my tongue, tastes like she might be the one.
I feel like there's gonna be a lot of innuendos in the song. I feel like I need to look up the lyrics.
Sorry, y'all.
Been trying hard not to overeat. If I'm allowed, I'll help you take.
Yeah, I wouldn't have caught that. Oh. All right, the next song is. Chihiro? Oh, this song, yeah.
When I come back around, well, I know what to say. Kinda strange. Feeling sorrow.
Billie does this thing, and I really, really like it. For her like really slow songs, or for the songs where she's like singing really, really softly, it's really hard to pay attention to the lyrics. Like for Lunch, you knew what she was saying, right? I did not need the lyrics, but for this one, I feel like I do. Oh, that was nice. The open up the. That was nice. Oh my God. Dude, this. I need the song in my fucking veins. Oh my God, this shit's gonna be crazy on stage. This is 100% a stage song. How long is this song? Damn. Sorry. That felt like the climax. Apparently not. This song is 5 minutes long.
And that's when you found me.
What the fuck is this song about? Oh, fuck. I don't know who's playing the guitar. It's probably Phineas. But that oh, God. Do you guys hear it? This kind of sounds like a 2014, like, EDM build-up. All right, good song. Gonna put Mark next to it. So far, all of the songs have marks next to it because all of the songs are good as fuck. Good song. I like it. I cannot imagine what it is about. Oh, man. I don't know how to explain. There are birds outside. I don't know how to explain that this is Billie Eilish, but this is also completely different than Billie Eilish, you know? Like, if you go back, listen to her discography, everything kind of has the same vibe. This has a completely different vibe. Like, it's darker, you know? And I like it. I like it quite a lot. Next song is Birds of a Feather. You're wrong. Dude, that acoustic guitar is going nuts. Okay. Oh, I don't know if it's gay, but it's really cute. Oh, I'm gonna put Mark next to it. Oh, that was really nice. This song is about finding your soulmate. Easy. Okay, sorry. All right, Wildflower. And then after Wildflower, I'm going to take a break and edit my current footage so that my phone doesn't run out of storage. Ooh, okay.
It's your heart. I wasn't there. I know it's closer until July. I see her in the back of my mind all the time.
Oh, that was nice.
Oh, good things don't look different.
That's a weird lyric. That's a strange lyric. I usually don't pause. Good things don't last and life moves so fast. I'd never ask who was better because she couldn't be more different than me. Happy and free in leather. Hey, genius. The fuck does that mean? Oh, okay. Never mind. All right. Never mind. We're good. Sorry, didn't mean to be weird. Didn't mean to be weird about it. I'm sorry.
Do you see her in the back of your mind? In my eyes.
Okay, first of all, this song is just like me. This song is good. This song is real good. It's really, really pretty. It's sad. It's great. I am going to go edit all of this. I'm gonna come back for the greatest. All right, it's been about like 2 hours, maybe. I edited all of it, and then I was like, I don't want to I don't want to work anymore. So then I called my friend and then I got boba and now I'm back. And now we're going to listen to The Greatest, which I've been excited for.
Did you get your rest? Let you come and go. Whatever state I'm in. Man, am I the greatest? My congratulations on all the times I waited for you to want me naked. Made it up when it's not worth fighting.
I should probably be speaking my mind here. I think this song might be about Billie Eilish fans. It sounds like it's about, but like anytime she writes songs about being famous or her fandom, it always sounds like a breakup song or just a really sad love song.
All my admiration, all the times I waited, I made it all the painless. Man, am I the greatest?
Hear me out. Theory. What if this is a concept album and The Greatest and Lunch are about the same person? Because Lunch is like, I think she might be the one, blah, 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 blah. And the same with Birds of a Feather. Like, those two can be connected. And then The Greatest. All right. That's my theory. Sorry. I don't know if the song is over. It basically is. Unless it goes into the next song. I don't know if that went into the next song. I think I might be crazy. All right, this one.
The rest of your life.
That does not sound like her.
Sorry for you when I looked in your eyes. I said you were the love of my life. Of my life.
That's upsetting.
You moved on immediately. I'm the one that I wish you the best for the love of my life.
Do you guys think, hear me out, do you guys think that when Taylor Swift released her album and one of the songs was Love of My Life, do you think that made Billie Eilish change the name of this song to Love of My Life in French?
I knew you thought I was depressed or losing my mind. My stomach upset almost all of the time. But after I left, it was obvious why. Because for you.
Good as fuck. Oh my god. I did kind of know where that was headed. because Genius put a part one and a part two for the lyrics. So I was like, oh, this song is gonna have like a bad guy type of switch, right? It still like surprised me. Like I was still caught off guard. And then there's also the outro is cameras, caught on camera, the girl on camera, the girls on camera. Your girl's a fan of Miss Me, say you miss me, such a pity, we're both so pretty. So that's the outro. I like the your girl's a fan of Miss Me. I like that. I think that's a good word. I think that's good wordplay. The next track is going to be The Diner. Ooh. Oh, that's so fucking. I could change your life. Woo! You could be my wife. I'm waiting on the corner till I saw the city leave. Was easy getting over and I landed on my feet. I can't move it. It's a number that is found on Eilish's website. When called, an automated recording of her will appear with the words, "Hey, hey, wait, I can't hear you. Hello, hello, hold on, call me back." When this contact is saved through WhatsApp, you can fill in a questionnaire to receive messages from Eilish. Okay. I mean, like, that's cool. Anyway, that song was good. That song was gay as hell. Like, this is an insane track, and I love it, and it's nasty. All the songs have marks next to them, by the way. This might be a 10 out of 10 album. This might be a no-skip album. This might have to go into my top 10, like, albums of all time list. All right, so the next song is Bittersweet. I got no spoiler. Maybe I should have gotten a spoiler. Okay, let me go to the lyrics real quick. I feel like this is gonna start really quickly. You were in the foyer. I was on my knees. Oh. Ooh. I gotta be careful. God, that bass is so that puts a wrench in my theory that they changed the name. Is this gonna lead into blue? It sort of goes into blue. Bittersweet was a good song. I'm not gonna put a mark next to it just because it was really, really long and it didn't really keep my attention for very long. And also, like, the lyrics were kind of repetitive. I wasn't really fucking with it. So no mark next to that song. But that it's still probably in the running for top 10, honestly. All right, listen to some blue. Yeah. I'm still so blue. Birds of a feather. was she going to say all the names in these verses? I don't fuck with that. I'm sorry. Who the fuck is this? Is that her? Is this Billy? Say the same means only 21. Means only 21 a week now. And I could say the same about you. Born blameless, grew up famous too. Just a baby born blue. I'm trying to figure out what the fuck that means. Ugh. Oh! Oh, is this how the album ends? All good.
But when can I hear the next one?
When can I hear the next one? Once again, the second part of that, song, I didn't really enjoy. I really liked the first part, and it might be because I've heard it, I guess, or whatever. I've heard the chorus of the first part, at least, but, I mean, like, 10 out of 10 album. I'm actually gonna give it, like, a 9.5, only because, the second parts of Bittersweet and Blue, I don't fuck with. But other than that, this album's great. Like, she's gonna win a lot of Grammys for it. Good job, Billy. Made album of the year again.